Tanzania, a country in East Africa, the home of amazing diversity of wildlife. The country is made up of 430 wildlife species and 17 national parks. The beauty and charm of wildlife in Tanzania also draws upon danger for those species, especially poaching of big elephants was apparent in 2010. It caused a great decline of number of elephants in the country, according to a specialist of governance and policy reform from Tanzania. It was an alarm for different stakeholders in the country.
Tanzania had more than 110 elephants, and it has reduced for about 60% in the span of 5 years. And that gives a message to the government that something has to be done. And since then, since when these corporations, this the government, the commitment, the political leadership that we have at the moment, started to work out, and they actually used the strategy I just mentioned about intelligence collaboration, involvement of multi-stakeholder agencies, involvement of non-state actors, all working together to address the illegal poaching. Now the things has improved significantly. We have never the incidences of wildlife poaching has been reduced. We've been receiving reports from the anti-poaching units that they have not found many elephant carcasses. So this gives a message that the poaching has gone down compared to to 5 years ago. So this is now a situation, and everyone actually is excited, and agencies are excited, and they are really looking forward to kind of working this, moving this ahead. The government of Tanzania is very highly committed to support the institutions, support the ministries, support the judiciaries, people who are doing field operations, put the boots on the ground, to kind of being able to address the illegal wildlife trafficking. And also there are multi-agency collaborations between different government institutions and within the government itself, like judiciary, Ministry of Natural Resources, and other agencies like police, all together fighting against wildlife trafficking. And also in Tanzania, there has been involvement of non-state actors, like civil societies, private sector, all working this together to address illegal wildlife trafficking. So, to Thailand, this is something I think they should learn and take that to fight the issues related to wildlife trafficking.
Political commitment from the government appears crucial in tackling illegal trade of wildlife. Election in 2015 was a big change as the new leadership of the country worked toward regulating wildlife management and hunting in Tanzania. Nevertheless, it is still very much challenging for the country, which relies on more than $2 billion revenue from wildlife. Hunting requires great attention and strong regulation from the country.
So Tanzania has a history of hunting, of regulated hunting. It's still very much a challenge to ensure that you have all of the correct science, the data, the quotas, to ensure that that the animals are being selected are older males, to ensure the survival of the animal population. So it's still a challenge in the country to get it right. It has in the past been a big income generation for the country. So there's still quite a lot of effort to try to get it well regulated. But it's a real challenge that we're still facing in Tanzania.
The expert on wildlife management offers that international commitment is also important in battling wildlife illegal trade. Thailand and Tanzania are also members of the Convention on International Trade in Endangered Species of Wild Fauna and Flora, or CITES, which can drive toward international cooperation to fight illegal trade of wildlife.
So in terms of laws, I mean, many, many countries in the world, Tanzania and Thailand included, are signatories to the Convention of the International Trade in Endangered Species, the CITES agreement. And so that's a key international agreement to keeping all of the countries moving towards the same goal of wildlife conservation. And there's a meeting going on right now in Geneva where all the countries are meeting, the signatories to the convention. So I think that's really key to keeping everyone moving in the good direction for conservation. That's in terms of laws. In terms of other ways of moving towards international cooperation, I think things like this journalist exchange that we're doing between Tanzanian journalists and Thai journalists, I think scientific exchanges, parliamentary exchanges. We brought some members of parliament over from Tanzania to Thailand to exchange what are they doing in their respective parliaments in terms of laws. I think all of these networks and international discussions and collaborations are important to learn best practices. We were just discussing this morning with your Deputy Director General about the issues in Thailand related to passage of animals and corridors, and we're dealing with the same issues in Tanzania right now. So I think there are many different levels, both legal, social, civil society, and scientific collaboration, I think can really help everyone in all of the different countries to move together in a collaborative way.
One aspect of combating wildlife trafficking is reducing consumer demand, which drives high prices. A lucrative profit from wildlife trafficking and results in the drastic decline of animal population. Raising awareness is important to support culture of wildlife protection. Natha Gomonwadin, Thai PBS World Reports.